Let us analyze graphical misrepresentations of data. So one thing when you are graphing or reading a graph, it is important to recognize if the graphs are done appropriately. Because if we have graphical issues, it's possible that they're trying to manipulate you with a graph that's incorrect. So a few things to note. When you look at the vertical axis, does it start at zero? Because if it doesn't, and sometimes there's a squiggle, there are ways to do this, but that is one way to misrepresent your data. Or if the tick marks are not spaced evenly, that can also change how the graph shows information. On the horizontal axis, again, not being spaced evenly, or different size of intervals. That different size of intervals could then lead to, if you're dealing with a bar graph, bars of different widths, right? If we have one bar that is three times as wide as another, your eyes are going to be drawn to that. It's going to just look different and odd, and those are graphical issues. Now, sometimes in pie charts, when we're dealing with circle graphs, the point of a circle graph is 100% of the data lies within that graph, and sometimes the percentages don't always add up. And that can be true in bar graphs as well. So we're just going to now take a look at a couple different graphs and how they are done inappropriately. So here we go. This is a bar graph. Percent who agreed with court. We've got Democrats, Republicans, Independents. Now the way this is given, what does this mean, right? Without more information, you're like, well, if you just talk to people, so a 100% is all the people you talk to, these three numbers should add up to 100%. Because if I'm talking the percent of people who agreed with court and then divvy them up by Democrats, Republicans, and Independents. But if you're saying like 62% of Democrats agreed, then that needs to be, the graph needs to be changed. This does not show, I think, what they intend to by the way it's presented. We have issues. Now, I like this graphic because it shows the good one on the right and the bad one on the left. So if we just focus on the graph on the left, we would say, wow, interest rates in 2012 are just ridiculously high compared to 2008. They're through the roof. Look how much taller that bar is, blah, blah, blah. But look at the y-axis, right? This is where we talk about starting at zero. So on the left, the vertical axis starts at 3.14. The tallest bar is 3.152. We're talking about a difference of like 12 thousandths of a percent. That is so small. And if you look at the graph on the right, where we start our y-axis at zero, you can see it's almost no change at all from 2008 to 2012. So this is where it's very easy to manipulate the data. Because so many people, when they look at graphs, they don't look at the axes. They look at the picture. They look at the graphic. And so the graph on the left, you look at the bars and you're like outraged because of the 2012 interest rates, when really they're not that different from 2008. Now, another vertical axis dealio, huge spike in average home prices. Oh my gosh, look how much bigger the bar is from year to year. But look at the vertical axis. Again, we've got, in 2014, that blue bar goes to 250,000, and in 2015, it's 252,000. Yes, that is an increase by 2,000 for an average. Is that huge? Is that a huge spike? I don't know. Again, if we would start our y-axis at a zero, or even if we did it squiggly and started it at 100,000, it would still show that this is a very, very minimum, or a minimal, if you will, increase. And then the last one for this graph is a circle graph. Now look at this. Again, a pie chart, pie graph, circle graph, whatever you want to call it. The point of these is that the graph itself is filled with 100% of data. So when I add these percentages, that should give me 100%, but it doesn't. Also, if you look at that, the light blue in the top right chunk of this, that says 52.9%, this represents high blood pressure. If the entire circle is 100%, 52 should be covering just over half of the circle. These percentages do not line up with what it should be in this graphic. Now, I think we could say, well, that's because some people have high blood pressure and arthritis and diabetes, so they're counted three times. Great, then we need a different graph. The bar, the circle graph is not the best representation for the data we have if that happens to be the case. So make sure when you're creating graphs that you're using the right graph to represent your data accurately. And when you are reading graphs, check your labels, check your axes, and make sure that you are not being taken for a ride, because oftentimes people try to manipulate us with a quick graphic without showing accurate information.
Yep.